So today we will be going into our social studies and art history unit. Our standard we'll be covering today is locate major topographical features of the Earth's surface. And our objective is going to be students will be able to identify through cultural identifiers the region that they belong to. Students will be able to point out the region on a map. So I pulled up this image of this painting. The name of this painting is Carnation Lily Rose. Can anybody tell me why they think that's the name? Maybe because those are names of flowers. And these are all carnations, lilies, and roses. So I'll tell you the story behind this painting. It was painted by a man named John Sargent, and he was living way back in the late 1800s. So this was painted in 1885, long time ago. He was traveling and he saw Chinese lanterns hanging from the trees, and he was in awe by these lanterns that were illuminating the night. And back then, it was not common to see things so special as lanterns. It would be a very special occasion. So he went back home to Great Britain, and he painted this image of two little girls in a garden, lighting up the garden at night with these lanterns. So there are a few things in this image that can help us to see that this was set in 1885, a long time ago. A few identifiers would be what they're wearing, what activity they're doing, and also to identify where this is, the garden helps us to identify that this is in Great Britain. These are flowers native there, and this is a typical landscape of Great Britain. Now, if we're looking at a map of the world, would we be able to point out where Great Britain is? It is actually right here in Europe. So this is Europe, and Great Britain is right on top. So we have all sorts of other regions, including North America, South America, Africa, Asia, the Middle East, and like we said earlier, Europe. So it would be really cool if we could understand and point out where each region is when people are talking about that region. Now, identifiers for those regions will be culture and landscape, and we would go over like a PowerPoint of different images of like all the different regions and link that together. So we're going to do a worksheet that will help us practice pointing out where each region is. So I have an image of identifiers for that region, and I want you to cut it out and put it on top of that world map. And then as a class, we'll go over it after everyone has completed it individually. Moving on to our next lesson, language arts and aesthetics. The standard that we will be covering in this lesson is ELA GSEKL1, demonstrate command and the conversation of standard English grammar and usage when writing and speaking. Our objectives would be the student will write and describe a piece of art with writing skills and grammar skills. class, what do you see here? What draws you into this painting in detail? So do you see any movement in this painting? Any action going on? How does it make you feel? Does it make you feel happy? Does it make you feel sad? Does it make you feel scared? Does it make you feel excited? Does it make you feel calm? Or maybe crazy? Well, another question I could ask is, what stands out? What's unique? What's different about this painting that you haven't seen in other paintings? So these are really good questions to look into this painting and start describing what's going on. And we want to use our describing words called adjectives. So if we were going to come up with some describing words for this, what would you say about this painting? Like, bright lanterns, and I would write this on the board, and I call on individuals. Other things I came up with: pink flowers, droopy flowers, many lanterns, green grass, little girls. These are all describing this painting. And so we're going to make our own short little poem. We're going to write 3 sentences, each of us, describing this picture. And I want you to work really hard on using the correct writing skills and grammar that we've learned. And if you need help, I will help. I will write an example sentence on the board so you know to remember to capitalize, to use periods, to use correct spelling and spacing. And then, once everybody's done with that, we're going to share with the class what we wrote, each student, and be able to say it out loud, which will help us make sure that we did the right grammar. And then the students will turn it in to me, and I will grade the writing skills. Our next lesson is our science project and our art. Oh, actually, it's a math and art criticism. And the standard that we'll be covering in this unit is MGSEKOA1. Represent addition and subtraction with objects, figures, mental images, drawings, sounds, acting out situations, verbal expressions, and equations. And our objective will be students will be able to look at a cluster of objects and estimate the number of items in that cluster. So if we're looking at this image that we have here, let's look into some detail about it. How many, is this image flat? Are the images inside this painting flat with no shape? Or are they more realistic with shape to them, which would be 3D? Does this image look like you could touch it and it could feel like there was texture? And what shapes did the artist use to create these images? artist put so many flowers? Is there a story behind this? Can you tell me the story? And all these questions I would let the students answer before I went on to the next. Would you put this painting up in your room? Like, do you enjoy what the artist did? What do you think he did well? What would you have done differently? And most importantly, after we've looked really into this, let's think about this painting in numbers. Okay, so how many girls are there? How many lanterns are there? Now, how many flowers are there? That's the question that's hard. We're looking at this painting and it's filled with flowers. How are we supposed to know how many flowers that is? It would take forever to count. So we're going to do something called estimating. So to add up all the flowers that we see here would take too long. We're going to have an estimated, we're going to have an educated guess of how many flowers there are. So we don't have to add up all the flowers and to spend like 10 minutes. And that seems hard looking at this large number of flowers, but we'll start off slow and we'll learn how to get a grasp on our number sense of how much a little bit is and how much a lot is and how that lies on a timeline. How about we do some practice? I'm gonna hold up, I know you guys are smart enough to do this activity. So show me really, really quick with your fingers how many objects you think this image is going to show. So how many is this? One. Very good. You guys see, you know it. It's easy. Really fast. Just think quick about how many objects there are generally. Four. It's okay if you said three, it's okay if you said five, just in that region. That was correct. How many do you think this is? Maybe like six? It's a little bit higher than the last one. That was very good. What about, let's say this one out loud because I don't think we can show it on our fingers. What about this? Maybe like 20? Around there? That was very good. So let's do a worksheet, and what it has is a cluster, and you're going to write in the box how many you think are in there. This is going to be timed quiz, so I'm going to give you 10 seconds to complete these problems. It's okay if it's not the exact number. We're not looking for the exact number. We're looking for speed and estimating the right number in around that range of what that exact number is. So we'll do that, and then we'll go over as a class how many it was and our strategies we use to estimate. Moving on with our next unit, which is science and art project. So we're looking at this image that I pulled up of the painting. And I want us to talk about what we see. What plants do you see? Is it daytime? Is it nighttime? Do you think, what's the weather like? Do you think it's negative 30 degrees? No, probably not, because there's flowers blooming. So the most important question I'm looking for here is, what season do you think this painting is showing? And what are, so let's go over what our four seasons are before we answer that. So we have spring, and spring is filled with flowers and baby animals, and there's a lot of rain. It's just when things start warming up and life comes out. And summer is when it gets hot. So there are a lot of flowers and animals out. We go play with the water at the beach. And fall is when it starts to cool down and things start to change again. The leaves fall off the trees, so we have different colored leaves. We have pumpkins growing, corn, Thanksgiving. And then winter is when it gets real cold. A lot of plant life isn't blooming at that time. There's sometimes snow. We dress warm. And going back to this painting, which one of those do you think is, which season do you think is shown in this painting? Yeah, I would say it's spring. And we're going to make our own piece of art using the seasons. So everybody's going to be able to pick a season that they want to draw in their piece of art. So we're going to make a landscape. This is a landscape. It is a garden. So if you want to draw a garden, or if you want to draw just your backyard or at the park, draw that season that you choose. And I'll put the PowerPoint up on the board so you can see different identifiers for each season that you can include in your artwork. So what we're going to do is everybody gets a white sheet of paper, and you're going to take your pencil, and we're going to draw a landscape. And once you have your landscape down, I'll come around and make sure that you are showing your season, if you need to add something, if you need to take things away. And then once your artwork is completed, you're going to color it with oil pastels. And we'll learn how to use oil pastels once everybody has their their image drawn. And then what I'm looking for in these pieces of art is I need it to be a landscape. I don't want to see just like a picture of a flower. I want to see like a garden or a yard with flowers in it. I need to see maybe some texture. We've practiced texture before to where you make it look like if you touched it, it would feel different. Value and proportion is important in this, in our landscape. So if things are really far away or if things are really close, I want to see that in the drawing and how you do your proportions. And when you're coloring, doing your value. So the artwork will be graded for accuracy of sticking to one season and using those identifiers, and then also for our art principles, like proportion, texture, and shape. And that is it for all of, oh, and creating a finished product. But that is it for all of the lessons. Thank you.